Welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we will be talking about how can we design several electronic modules that can be used as a signal conditioning system and that can be interfaced with sensors and transducers of our interest, so as to get the electronic side of the system, realization of the electronic side of the system. So to start with, we will look at several components, or you can say several circuits, and their respective videos. I'll discuss with you so that you can understand in detail what are those circuits. So if you see the slide, we will be looking at the basic building blocks that finally will be integrating together to form an entire signal conditioning unit. Right. To start with, we will go and understand how we can use the op amps as amplifiers. And we'll talk about several kind of amplifiers, starting from non-inverting, inverting, unity amplifier, summing amplifier, and differential amplifier. Why exactly you use this? Because you have to integrate your sensor to this kind of amplifiers to amplify your signal. Then we'll look at the filters. Several type of filters: low pass, high pass, band pass, band reject. Again, the use of filters is to filter out the unnecessary components, that is your noise from the signal. Then we'll go for data converters, and we'll look at how the ADCs and DACs work. This is to convert your analog data to digital domain, so they can interface with the microcontroller and a display. Finally, you have signal conditioning circuits, which is resistor divided network, Wheatstone bridge network, and instrument amplifier. These circuits can be used at the starting of the stage, as the first block of the stage, where you can interface your sensor directly on the Wheatstone bridge, or you can use a potential divider network, which is resistor divided network, or you can, and then followed by the instrumentation amplifier circuit. So let us see the videos of each of those in detail. Not really videos. I'll show you the things in detail one by one in the following slides, and then we will continue in understanding how we can bring all things together to form a entire electronic module. All right. So till then, let us see the first block, which is your amplifiers. Now in this module, let us see how we can use op amp as non-inverting amplifier. Okay, so let us see how op amp can be used as a non-inverting amplifier. So let us come back on the screen, and you will see the circuit here. What is the case? The case is that we have applied the input voltage, or we have applied the signal to the non-inverting terminal of the operation amplifier, as you can see here, right? We still have the feedback resistors R1 and R2. We still have feedback resistors R1 and R2, and here the inverting terminal is grounded, non-inverting terminal is given the signal. Okay. So if I see the non-inverting closed loop configuration, first is external components R1 and R2 forms a closed loop, right. First point is that external components R1 and R2 forms the closed loop, is similar to the inverting amplifier. Second is output is fed back to the inverting input. Output here is fed back to the inverting input, correct. Third, input signal is applied from the non-inverting terminal. Input signal is applied from the non-inverting terminal, right. All three things we understand, very easy, right. Super easy to understand. One is R1 and R2 forms a closed loop. Second, the inverting input is grounded and output is fed to the inverting input. Third is the input signal is given to the non-inverting op amp. Now, non-inverting op amp using ideal configuration. If it is ideal, then we have required conditions to apply for virtual short for op amp circuit is negative feedback and infinite open loop gain. Right. Now, closed loop gain G is nothing but VO by VI is 1 plus R2 by R1. Now, this we already know, it's a very basic. So, let us see, R1 is here, which is grounded, right, R2 is here, and then because of the virtual ground concept, we have difference voltage 0. The whatever voltage is at this non-inverting terminal, same voltage you will have at the inverting terminal because of the concept of virtual ground. Now, if I see that, then what will I find? That this current here is nothing but V by R1, here will be V by R1, VID equals to 0 volts, or what we can further find it, that VO is nothing but VO will be V o will be V 1 plus V 1 by R 1 into R 2, right, V 1 by R 1 into R 2. This is nothing but if I have V 1 common, then V 1 common 1 plus R 2 by R 1, right, 1 plus R 2 by R 1. So, my V o is nothing but 1 plus R 2 by R 1, all right. This is my output voltage, which is 1 plus R 2 by R 1, all right. So, this is what is closed loop gain. Inverse infinite differential gain we have seen is nothing but it should be 0. Infinite input impedance is V 1 minus R, V 1 V minus divided by R 1, right, because R 1 is the input. 0 output impedance will be output voltage. Closed loop gain depends entirely on external passive components. That is, we have seen what does it mean by external passive components. Then we have seen closed loop amplifier trades gain. We have also seen this exactly similar concept in the inverting, in the inverting amplifier. So, equivalent circuit model, if I want to draw, input impedance is infinite, right, output the gain is 1 plus R 2 by R 1 into V, output voltage we have written here, output impedance is 0, gain is nothing but 1 plus R 2 by R 1, gain is nothing but 1 plus R 2 by R 1. So, you have to remember that the most of the things are similar to the inverting amplifier, except that now since the input is applied to the non-inverting terminal, my output signal would be in phase to the input signal. That means, if I apply an input signal at this particular terminal, right, my output will be amplified, but in phase, right. So, this is 0 degree, this is also 0 degree. This is output is in phase when you compare with the input signal, all right. That is why it is non-inverting, it is a non-inverting amplifier. So, let us take an example of non-inverting op amp, all right. So, find the closed loop gain of following non-inverting amplifier circuit. If RF equals to 100 kilo ohm, RN equals to 10 kilo ohm. We have RF value, we have RN value, right. Now, what is the formula? Formula for non-inverting amplifier is 1 plus RF by RN, this is gain, right. And if I have VO, then VO will be nothing but V 1 plus RF by RN into VIN, right. This is my formula for non-inverting amplifier, correct. So, given RF equals to 100 kilo ohm, which is given here, R 1 is 10 kilo ohm, AV or V gain, right, is 1 plus RF by RN. So, if I put the value of RF and RN, I have AV equals to 1 plus 100 by 10. So, 100 by 10 is what? 10. So, 1 plus 10 is nothing but 11. 11 plus 10 is nothing but 11. Therefore, the closed loop gain of the inverting amplifier circuit is 11 or 20.8 dB. This we can get by substituting value of by converting the value of gain into decibels by using 20 log of gain, 20 log of gain or 20 log of 11, which is equal to 20.8 decibel. Easy, super easy, right? Because you have to just substitute the value of the resistors in the given equation. So, let us find another, let us solve another problem, okay. So, this problem is that the gain of the original circuit is increased to be 40. You see similar example, right. Find the values of resistors. Required. So, given AV equals to 40, we know that AV the gain is nothing but 1 plus RF by RN, or 40 equals to 1 plus RF by RN. RN is 10 kilo ohm. So, RF can be 390 kilo ohm, right. RF can be 390 kilo ohm. This is super easy to understand. And that is why let us move to the next problem. The next problem is, calculate the voltage gain of for each stage of this amplifier circuit, both as ratio and in units of decibel. Then calculate the overall voltage gain. So, you have given amplifier like this. You see, there are two stages here, where applying the input at the non-inverting terminal and the output is again applied to the another amplifier at the non-inverting input, right. The output of the first amplifier is fed to the input of the non-inverting terminal of the second op amp, right. Here what we are asked? We are asked to find the value of AV, we are asked to find the value of overall voltage gain and also the voltage gain for each stage, voltage gain for each stage, ok. So, the you see a circuit may look complex, but the solution is very easy. Now, you see just stage 1, stage 1 is what? Non-inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier, what is the formula? Formula is 1 plus Rf by R1, right. So, what is Rf? 3.3, R1 4.7. So, AV equals to 1 plus 3 by 3 divided by 4.7 is nothing but 1.702. Let us consider stage 2, stage 2, what is formula? 1 plus Rf by R1, AV equals to 1 plus 9.1 divided by 2.2 equals to 4.136, because 9.1 divided by 2.2 will give us 3.136, 3.136 plus 1 will be 4.136. So, we now know AV2 as well, right. So, if I convert my AV1 into decibels, it is 20 log 1.702 or it will be 4.6 decibels. If I convert my AV2 into decibels, I will have 20 log 4.136 or 12.3 decibel, correct. Therefore, the overall gain of the non-inverting amplifier is, overall gain is AV1 into AV2 is 1.702 into 4.136 equal to 7, equal to 7. Now, again I can want to convert my gain in decibels, then I have to use 20 log 7, 20 log 7, that will give me value of 16.9 decibels, that will give me value of 16.9 decibels, right. This is how we can find the solution for the non-inverting amplifier given a problem to you, given a problem to you, alright. Till then you take care, I will see you in the next class.